Tommy, it's been a busy week. Delighted to announce the appointment of Paul Tisdale today. What has your kind of role in that been, and what's your thoughts?
Well, as we've mentioned, you know, the process of or the timeline for the football club was as such. We felt that we needed to put a manager in as quickly as we could. I mean, like everybody's been talking about, everybody has a role to play at the club, the playing staff, the backroom staff, and obviously the man at the head of the diamond is the manager. So we feel Paul's skill set, married with what's already in place, is a really, really good fit, and hopefully both will make things go along a little bit quicker.
You've been on the grass with the players this week, you were in the dugout last night. That's invaluable knowledge to pass on to a new manager coming in, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, like Paul's mentioned himself, you know, he knows the football club well. He'll know the players in terms of he knows who they are, but he doesn't know them like I'll know them, because obviously I've been in depth in terms of before they came to the club. I've done a lot of research on them as people as well as footballers, and of course me being with them and over the last few days especially, and then in the dressing room last night, I can give them a little bit more info which is relevant to the manager rather than just being relevant to everybody. So, you know, I'm really looking forward to the relationship blossoming further with Paul, but I've known him a long time. Like I said, I think he's the type of guy that not only is going to be very beneficial for the young guys, but also for the group in general. And I think the Gas are very lucky to have him.
Talk about that relationship. Obviously, with your role and the manager's role, they're very closely tied, aren't they?
Very, very closely tied. I think people, up until probably very, very recently, don't realise what I did. I mean, sometimes titles at clubs are skewed or, you know, misplaced and stuff. But ultimately, my role is to help the manager as much as I can, make his job as easy as it is, and let him manage the team. Manage the team, develop the youngsters within the team, and then win football matches primarily. The first thing is winning football matches is will help the other side, other facets of the strategy. Players don't develop in teams that don't win enough games. It's simple as that. Individually, they do in development football, but not in first team football.
Obviously, talking about titles, I understand that yours is slightly changing into a director of football role. Mm-hmm. What does that entail? What does that involve? And obviously, that cements your place on the board of directors and work closely with Martin Starnes and our owner to kind of build success in long term in this football club.
Well, like I said, the title's changing, but the remit isn't that different. I mean, roughly now since Christmas of 2018, I've been doing all of those roles anyway. So the head of recruitment was the title I took when I joined the club, but I would say, you know, I've been doing a little more than just scouting as such. So I think it's more for the general public to know what's going on, and I'm delighted to be offered a position on the board, but the director of football just clarifies what it is. I'm there as the head of the football operation, and that's brilliant. I'm really delighted. It's an honour to be that, and it was really great to, like you say, be on the grass and in the dugout with the team. And my skill set is from there down to there. You know, I'm as comfortable on the grass as I am in the boardroom. So it's something I look to develop myself further. You know, I'm a young guy to be on a board of directors. So from that point of view, it's really, really exciting times, and I'm delighted to be doing it.
Obviously, speaking to the different personnel this week, Martin, Paul, yourself, everyone's long-term strategy is aligned, isn't it? How great is that to see that everybody's on the same page to build a plan to make Bristol Rovers successful in the future?
It's absolutely imperative. I think, you know, especially in these weird and wonderful times we're living in, you know, without the fans in the ground, there's got to be strategic plans from top to bottom at the football club. And any change made, it has to have a continuum. It's simply as that. And we were lucky, if you like, in terms of Paul being available and him, after discussions, understanding that the role that he's coming in to do fits exactly with what we're planning. He's not going to change the world inside the football club. He's going to fit into what we want, and he's going to try and implement what he does well within what we do well. And I'm excited by that prospect.
And lastly, you won't be in the dugout any longer, but I'm guessing now that your attention now turns to further beyond. You know, January's not that far away. That window is going to be an important one as you build on the recruitment done this summer previously.
Yeah, of course. I mean, in my role as the head of recruitment or the director of football now, what I'd say is I try to work at least two windows ahead. And of course, this window is very, very close on the back of the last one, which was the longest window in the history of football. So we did a hell of a lot of business in January and the long window. So, you know, Paul last week wouldn't have realised that he would have been involved anyway. So I'll be suggesting and showing him what the status of the current squad is, and we'll discuss in depth between us. And ultimately, he'll make a decision on whether we want to bring anything further in. And if we can, if there's scope financially, obviously, then I'll speak to Martin and stuff like that. So like I said, the process is in place. The only thing that's going to be different will be the person making the decisions, picking the team, deciding what the coaching and the development required on the grass will be Paul. So that's where we are.
And finally, just touch on the supporters. I know we mentioned it a little bit in the run up to Wednesday's game, but there's a network of scouts that work for you, isn't there? And yeah, people around the country all feeding information back into you. It's a group job, isn't it?
Absolutely. I am the head of the department, but it's like anything. It's like being the manager of the football team. You don't do the medical side of it. You don't do the nutritional side of it. You let the people underneath you do that, give you the information required, and you then have to filter that into what you do. The information I filter is directly to the manager. The manager gets the information from me. I get it from the people that I've got all over the country who travel a long way and in all sorts of conditions at all sorts of times. We're the guys who do the hard yards, if you like, but ultimately it's what we do well. And that information is given to the manager and between me and the manager, and of course has to fit into the fiscal opportunity of the football club. And if it all marries, then we all win.